Bill, this has to be one of the stars of the show, the PXW FS7. Where does this fit in?
Okay, Rick, yeah, you're right. It is today's hot product. In terms of positioning, it really does sort of sit between the FS700, which, don't forget, is a 4K camera, 4K sensor, and the F5. Okay, with the 4K sensor as well. So they're all basically using the same super 35mm size sensor. And this is primarily aimed at sort of documentary, budget movie makers, that start, you know, people have been using the FS700 for some years.
I hear the words you're saying, but it looks like it could be used for extremely high-end work as well. So talk to me about, I mean, I can see XQD is the cards it records onto. So what does it record internal? That's pretty important.
So this records 4K. You remember I was talking about XAVC, and again, one of the benefits of XAVC, it allows us to record 4K. So we're using both long-op and intra 4K recording up to 600 megabits per second.
That's phenomenal. I'm still trying to work out why this isn't higher end than what we're talking about. What are the outputs on the back of it?
Two HDSDIs.
Two HDSDI?
And that includes also a 4K RAW output.
And 4K RAW. That means so you can do anything with this camera.
We had 4K RAW output from the FS700, you may remember. And this uses the same RAW output, which we've now called FS RAW. So this allows you to go and use a third-party recorder to get 4K RAW, which is fantastic.
And what about the lens mount? What have we got hiding under there?
So the lens mount, again, in a similar sort of vein to the FS700, we've used the popular Sony E-mount, which is really flexible because basically, because it's short flange back, you can adapt it to use any lens you want. Of course, Sony have got a whole range of E-mount lenses, which are really good. And we're actually shipping this product in two formats. So body only, and a K version with this lens. Now this lens is also new. It's a new zoom lens, 28mm to 135mm, quiet zoom, badge G, but it's got all the professional features you'd expect from an ENG style lens. It's really cool.
I think this will be a very popular camera because it's got so much on offer. And even if it's targeted as being maybe not as high up in the realms as the F5, it sure looks to me that will compete with that sort of product.
Of course. I mean, it shoots HD 422 10 bits, 50 megabits. So, you know, it does hit that sweet spot for broadcast as well. So many different applications.
Yeah, and it's able to be shoulder mounted, which has always been something that people are crying out for.
Yeah, it's got a really nice shoulder mount system. We've got a new grip system at the front here. We've built it so it can actually be positioned anywhere on the body. So you can actually take it from the shoulder downwards if you want to adjust your shot. So we thought long and hard about the ergonomics. And one of the things we've also done is spoken to a lot of freelance cameramen and asked them, you know, what they want in the camera, how they want to work with it, you know, what the benefits or the downsides were of their existing large format sensor cameras, whether that be a DSLR or another type of product, one of ours or one of our competitors' products, and really said, look, how can we maximize the ergonomy for you guys? The other thing about this is it's really exceptionally light as well, because we're actually using magnesium as opposed to aluminium for the body. So the body only is only about 2K, so it's really, really low in weight. Again, if you're working all day with a product on your shoulder, you've got to think about having that much weight, and minimizing the weight as possible can only be a good thing.
I hear you loud and clear. And if you take that whole front section, that lens forward away from it, and you use photographic lenses, you can have lenses that big, and it reduces the whole size of the camera in a big way. And what about what we've got on the back here? How much of this is integral to the camera and how much of it is bolt-on?
So this is the bolt-on XDCA FS7 unit. Primarily, it's been designed for people who want to use the camera in a more ENG style. So it gives you access to use the VLOC batteries as opposed to the BPU batteries, which we know and love from the XD Cam EX days. So it gives you longer recording time, but it also allows you to use it in more of a studio configuration because it's got your time lock, your gen lock, etc., etc.
What I'm getting from this is that's it. That's all you need to worry about. That doesn't come with it. Lens is optional. You stick a BPU battery on there and a lens and you're away in something that's half the size of what we're looking at. Does the viewfinder come with the camera?
Yes, it does. Yes, very much so. And the viewfinder is very, very high resolution. Obviously, you need a high resolution viewfinder to be able to focus for 4K. But also, we've made it modular so you can fit it wherever you want. So if you're shooting high, you're shooting low, you can adjust the viewfinder to how you like it. I mean, the XQD is the new consumer memory card. So again, should be accessible in many different, more places than maybe S by S1, which is more of a professional card. Again, it gives you high data rate and high storage capacity, which is exactly what you need when you're starting to talk about 4K recording.
Yes. And as we already talked about with the SDIs out the back, you can use external recorders if you need or want something different.
Yeah, if you want RAW, but I mean, it's packed full of codecs anyway, so you can literally use it however you want to play it. Another nice feature as well, you'll notice that I've mentioned this before, but it's got the UWPD, so it's got the MI shoe on it. So again, no messy audio cables, no extra power. You can have a nice, if you're in a documentary situation, you're usually going to use some form of wireless mic. So again, you know, we've thought about that style of shooting as well. So it's not just ENG people who can enjoy the benefits of the MI shoe, but also people who want to shoot more cinematically.
Talk to me about the pricing.
The price, I mean, it's just a little bit higher than the FS700. So we're looking at what we're going to do with the FS700. We may well look at putting it in a different price point. So it offers tremendous value for money. And, you know, I'd love to be able to get you guys to have spend more time with it, maybe do a review or whatever, so we can spread the word externally on that.
All right, let's follow up on that one.
Definitely.
Bill, fantastic.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
Take care.
Great to see you.
Bye.